So I want to show you how to make your microphone sound from this to this. Have you ever wondered why there's like a humming or high pitch noise in your recording? Well, that's what I want to go over today. I want to show you how to use a noise suppressor properly and a noise gate properly in OBS to make your microphone sound the best it can. I'm sure you're asking, what is a noise gate and what is noise suppression? Well, I plan on teaching you that today. So I'm fascinated with tech, and one of my goals with this channel is to show you how you can make your channel, videos, live streams look and sound as professional as they can and make it simple for you. So if that interests you, please hit that subscribe button and follow along. I've been recording audio for years using programs like Pro Tools and Waves plugins, but what I want to do is navigate those skills towards using free programs like OBS and other free VST plugins and show you how you can use those on your channel easily. So follow along. At the end of the video, I'm going to show you a free plugin you can use to get rid of those sharp S sounds. So let's get into it. If you're watching this, I'm assuming you already know how to add a source and add your mic input. If not, I do have another video about getting the best microphone settings out of any microphone, and where I do go over all these free OBS plugins and or audio filters, and then I also talk about these free VST plugins to make it sound even more better. So if you want to check those out, I'll put a card at the end of the video to link you to those. And the reason why I'm doing this video is in those videos, I didn't really go over like the benefits of noise gate and noise suppression. So that's what I wanted to take this opportunity to do. Okay, so I know you're wondering, what's a noise gate and how to properly set it up? Well, this is OBS's website. It's pretty clear cut. They say a noise gate allows you to cut off all background noise while you are not talking. Select a closed threshold above the noise volume and an open threshold slightly below your voice input to get good results. And the way I can easily explain this is it's literally a gate that's opening the audio signal and closing the audio signal. Easy. Now, what is noise suppression? OBS says the noise suppression filter can be used to remove mild background noise or white noise that may be in any of your audio sources. While this is generally not effective at large amounts of background noise, like a loud room, it can be quite effective at reducing things like PC fan noise and other environmental noises. Zero is off. The further you move the slider to the left, the stronger the filter will be and the more sounds it will filter out. Keep in mind that this can distort other sounds like your voice. So this is huge. This is why I like to set the noise suppression at about the same volume that I'm speaking, and I'm going to switch over and show you that now. All right, so here we are on the noise suppressor. No, here we are in the noise suppression. So what I'm going to do is I can't talk while I do this because it does weird things to your voice. So I'm going to slide this slider down. I am going to slide this slider down and you'll hear what it's doing and why you need to use this. I'm going to set it really high. I don't even know what this is doing to my voice. I wonder if I do sound weird. All right, so I want to show you on this voice meter. You see this black little portion? This is where my voice is coming in at before all these filters. So that's why I like to set it right at about negative 23. I'm actually going to move it to negative 25, which is where like my voice is normally. Okay, there we go. And I'm going to completely shut it off so you can hear how it sounds without. Pretty weird, right? All right, now the noise gate. Noise gate is exactly what I was explaining before. Opens a door, closes a door. Now what I like to do is go about 5 to 10 decibels or more below of where I'm speaking. So I'm at about negative 30, negative 25, somewhere in there. But like when I talk quietly, my voice is a little low. So that's why I set it at negative 42. So it closes the door and shuts anything off below this volume. And just one more time, I'm going to click them both off just so you can hear what it sounds like. Now I had my heater on before in the intro. Now it's not on, but there's still noise. So you can see why these are must to have on your audio chain. So here is the noise suppression turned on. You can tell that difference. Here's the noise gate. Easy. Set them, forget them. That's all you have to do. Now I want to show you the VST Nova. So this is my VST Nova setup. And actually what I want to do while I'm in it, I want to decrease the gain because I know my S's are a little sharp. So I'm going to decrease the gain on my about 6 decibels. But when I do an S, it's about half the volume. And then the same on this, I'm going to decrease this about 6 decibels. What I like to do is reduce my S's and boost my mid lows. So that way my voice sounds a little deeper and more for broadcast, and it carries through speakers like on your phone or TV or whatever you're watching this on. I would suggest that you watch my advanced mic settings and VST plugins to properly show you how to add this and all the other VST plugins that you might have seen on my chain right here, and my mic settings for any mic, to go through how to set up your compressor, your limiter, and just get your mic sounding the best it can. But now that we have your noise reduced and we understand what that's doing, watch one of those videos to set up your mic further. I'd like to know if this video helped answer some of your questions or eliminated the mystique of noise suppression and a noise gate. So let me know in the comments just by saying I get it. Or if you have any questions, let me know there as well. If you do like the music playing in the background, it's called Stream Tunes Lo-Fi Beats. It's a playlist on Spotify that I'm building. So please check that out. And other than that, thank you for your time, and we'll see you on the next video.